I can't believe we're talking about the same thing for the fourth time. We can't hear you.
Introduction time.
There you go.
Hi, this is John McKeon. I'm Mike Kunkel with the CCAC and I live in Fort Farm.
Doug Bates, CCAC.
Leslie Burns, St. George Avenue, CCAC.
Paul Brady, I live in Phoenix Prairie.
I'm Jennifer Warren, the liaison for the organization. Kim Gunther, CCAC, I live on Dorms Gamble.
Crozet had at their previous meeting
be able to respond to questions about the scope of the project to make sure that design people can bring in to help turn the project into, help turn the idea into a project that can then be reviewed by the board. Yeah, so we just wanted confirmation from you that things are just sort of a minute on the process. The board approved that each CAC area would get up to $200,000 allocated for the project for your area. I've had some questions. Does that mean that the board is writing a check to all the CACs for $200,000? No. The idea is that that we'll go through scoping committees this summer and early fall, and then depending on the results of that scoping, that the CAC would make a recommendation for supervisors to fund a project or two projects, depending on where the costs sort of wind up, and that the board then would take an action on that, probably for November. So what is scoping? Scoping is, again, turning an idea into an actual project. Before the county goes out with any major capital project or even a study, some initial course study is done through the scoping phase to look at what would it really cost to do the project, what are some of the challenges versus the constraints, will land need to be acquired, will easements need to be required, are the utilities need to be relocated, that kind of stuff. It'll give us a firmer cost estimate and a firmer schedule for how long it might actually take to implement. So that's the work that we're going to be doing this summer. If you had come to this meeting with a list of five projects, we're going to ask you to winnow that list down to one or two or three. We'll sort of advance those top projects on for the scoping process. You may have put them on your way-in, a black and white sheet that looks like this is black and white on one side. That is the pile. This is what we're going to give to the consultants to work on. The front is a cover sheet, the back side is a table of contents. And that just outlines the text of things, again, that they'll be looking at when they do this work, this scoping work. So they'll look at the purpose and the scope of the project, look at some history. They'll, for places where the location might be less firm, we hone in on that location, a site description, and assess what the current existing conditions are. They'll give a conceptual drawing of what a finished project might look like on the ground. They'll look at an estimate and a schedule, and then they'll make conclusions and recommendations. So it's possible at the end of scoping that a project might be deemed infeasible for whatever reason, constraints that might come up through their study. Again, we're not expecting that with any of these projects. Staff have taken a look at all the projects for all CAC areas. We feel like all of them seem generally feasible and implementable. But there are things sometimes that we uncover when we do a study that suggest that the cost might be a lot higher than we thought, or that there's just something that's insurmountable that just doesn't make it a good choice. The first week of August, we'll have all the projects from all the CAC areas to go into scoping. We'll divide all the projects up based on what the project is and sort of assign it to a consultant to do that scoping work for us. They'll all fill in this template with the information and return it back to you this fall. Based on the content of the scoping for all the projects that we do for each of the areas, the group again will do a recommendation for supervisors and board supervisors and expect to take action on that endeavor. Any questions on the process?
It's my understanding that if we want to get the matching funds, we have to have the application in by sometime in November.
I'm not 100% on the date, but I talked to the transportation planner on staff today. He spoke with the Culver District representative also today, and they feel comfortable that if this project is a project that seems like that we would want to put in for transportation revenue sharing funds, that we could make the level of information that you need to put in the application is lower than the actual construction documents, and that they are both comfortable with the level of information that we would be able to have by that deadline to get that in.
So when the board supervisor is making a decision in November, what does that mean in terms of when the funding that it needs to be in November or following
year? The funding source is from fiscal year 16 funds that are being held in a fund right now, so they'll be available
So once the design and cost are ready, then it just goes through a advertising or whatever.
Yeah, whatever the next would be. Yeah, whatever the next piece would be, that could start the day after the board takes the action.
Since this last year's money, we don't have to wait until the end of July, so there is a fund, which is great.
And it's been appropriated into a fund for this project, for the whole NIFI project. So we won't have to wait for another appropriation.
Plaza work in the future, so the engineers on those two projects need to work together, so to make sure
Things will be smooth and won't be different elevations and other conclusions.
Are you going to have to put out the engineering work for the square for bids?
My understanding is that people who have already, a lot of information has already been gathered when the streetscape was being planned. So that is what I was told for the first step. And with all of that, they also work with the folks that are really excited about the plaza. So that information is being gathered, and they just need to make sure that it all lines up.
John?
Yes.
Since Dan mentioned the plaza, Meg Holden posted a meeting last week for the DC.
DCI. I was merely chairing it, but DCI had a meeting.
And I wonder if you want to bring this group up to speed on that vote actually.
Well, we seem to make a lot of progress, strangely enough. It was a small meeting last week, but we meet every month. That has been generally trending on the first Thursday of the month, and it's at noon, and generally at the library, but we've been very blessed to get to meet also at the rooftop when the library's not busy. So that's nice. And we've had a lot of different people come and show up. So the purpose of that meeting was to really dig in. We kind of changed the purpose because some people couldn't come, and dig into the 501c3 piece. So I feel like we got a lot of great feedback on that. And after meeting the small subcommittee that's been working, on that as well, for the plans, we've been really, really fortunate that Pat Group, for anyone who knows her, she has given up her time, she's a consultant, she's given a lot of her time to help us through this. And then Suzanne Reed, they've been kind of helping with the nuts and bolts and doing the writing, which will then come out. Anyone can see any of this. But we actually kind of were off and running. I went and rented a mailbox. Pat has been in touch with the bank. They do some money to actually, they often will give money to these efforts, community development type efforts. So she's talked to BB&T about that. And in the meantime, I think we get a free bank account. So we're about to be in business, I think. So because we were just there, Suzanne Reed was drafting a lot of the documents for us. So we needed to have people, like officers, to start. So it's right now, it's me and Brenda. And Suzanne just didn't want, but we will expand that, of course. And probably will, over time, be 12 people, a rotational thing. But it looks like we will eventually, hopefully the not too future, have a way to raise money for the square. Next month's meeting, Frank, but next month's meeting, I'm hoping Frank will be there and be able to update us on where that stands. And I know he's been working diligently to get some other sources of funding with the county, and you may know something of that. So anyway, it's moving. Thank you. You were at the meeting too. Doug was there. So if you all have anything, that's sort of big, broad brush strokes.
Is there a fine price tag on the
and all those final design?
Correct.
Presentation that you're at.
And that's been sort of the thing that we are all eager to know, so that we have some sense of what we need. And that'll come with the county, but I think there's also all those various features. We have a design, but we don't know. We want to break it down so that if we can start out with all of those pieces, we know how to sort of build it, or someone can sponsor the water feature, fund the water feature. Yes. Well, yeah. They should be here because, in fact, Pat Root sent me the minutes from the very first DCI meeting that she found on the website. So, that's true. But Kim, I think you're on the
list. Oh, yeah, I've seen the meeting announcements, but I haven't seen them.
We don't send them out. It's not a ahead and send everything out to the 350 names or 400 names that we have. Or we just, I mean, some people say they don't want everything coming to their inbox because we have so much coming from the county and the Crozet Community Advisory Council and the CCA. So we'll do whatever. It was a topic, so it'd be great to know what you all think. If you want a lot of things sent out from the group to that large mailing list, we are more than happy to do it. There are people like people who come to the meetings regularly and are sort of part of the planning work we're doing are on a, like, you know, what, 15, 20 of us are on the email just to keep the work going. That would be way too much email, I think, for everybody. But when we're done with the meetings, I'm happy. Maybe you all should tell me if you want us to send it out. That would answer a question we have.
Well, I want it, but I don't
know. I mean, you and Jake hasn't been lately, but he used to come between you. Generally, Jenny's often there. I feel like somebody is there that can get that email. You're almost all those smaller emails. Somebody, let us know. If you want to be on everything, it is all, we're happy for you to be on. I just don't like getting the emails myself. But anyway, it's exciting. We're getting there, I think. Is there anything I should say?
Well, I just think that the position of this group to support improvements to the square is just a catalyst for the plaza, and it makes a lot of sense.
It's always going to be at the library on that first Thursday in August. Just soon.
Is it the third?
And then does Frank kind of talk about how his search for tenants folks to have it at development? Does he talk about that with them?
He'll talk about anything you want to. He's very transparent.
I just wondered how that progress is going. I mean, I know the room is in there, but is there anybody else that's kind of...
He has got a list of really cool people that are very interested. And he is working so hard. But in point of fact, the plaza, a lot of people, they feel the plaza will drive commerce. So, and Kim and I had a very brief meeting on the run the other day, kind of prompted to each other. But it is really a driver for economic growth, I do believe, because it's going to be a social center where people can. They're going to want to eat, drink, you know, shop, listen to music, and then naturally the businesses, you know, then you have people that want to have an office there, like the downtown mall, and that office space is kind of crazy. And one of the guys that was there, first time ever at a company meeting, represents a very large company, he's their CFO, and he had lots of great questions, about that piece of it. So I think, for a lot of people, that is going to say that we, the community, support this. We want it. We're going to all go there and patron it and shop, spend our dollars, and bring our employees there and set up our businesses there. So I think he can't commit to anybody until that is done. He's been working with Doug. Do you remember Paul? What's the name of? He got something from Richmond, the Muni Cap. So, and that's helping the county, I think, get some money. It's a way for the county to borrow money, I do believe. So he's been working on that. So it's all, you know, that's a great question.
Yeah, and Frank really can't demolish the density of some people who are interested until, you know, they sign a contract.
Most of those businesses probably aren't prospects for paying for plaza.
But certainly okay, you know, property.
Yes, absolutely. And I think what I see happening is like if you have a hotel and there are fire pits that they have outside the hotel or plaza, maybe they maintain that component of it. You know, the reason that it seemed to make sense to have this nonprofit is so that the community, yes, one thing drives the other, but they kind of help, they're kind of interconnected. And so maybe we could have some control over the types of events we host and you know, hopefully one would assume every business that's located somewhere close by would contribute to that 501c3. I don't know that it's interesting, because I wonder if you could ask them to say that, you know, almost like where they go, like, do you have homeowners? Is there a homeowners association you pay for? People pay. So you wonder if there couldn't be something like that. You have to make a contribution to the laws. Well, I
mean, the business is so complicated.
Well,
asking for a
proper. Yeah,
well, you do have.
regulars from Washington, which were on the media, and second of all, lots of work. So a relook at that issue and how the sort of natural experience part along the bottom that's preferred, and a smaller playing field to fit into the places where it can be, similar to what's going on now, where you have practices going with the local teams who are being placed back. There isn't a full-size 50-by-100-yard field here. That's the sort of thing that the students have. There is a very large two-story pavilion, very pretty, but not really in the classroom. So I think it's important to have a discussion about, is that still what people want to wait for X million dollars to build that? Or do people really want to have something else first, instead?
So this isn't that I'm all,
is that just the material?
This is just the material. So 101 per 100 foot length is the quote from the project management. And they called up one of our suppliers.
The part that I would like to see, the part that I put in the proposal is about a mile and a half altogether. So that's about, I did a little Googling, about 9,000 feet. So that kind of gives you a sort of estimate. Still comes in at under 50,000 and it's volunteer labor. So if y'all get out your shovels and come visit.
It's a little rock out there.
Anything else anyone wants to talk about for the NIFI stuff?
I have one question on the NIFI. I know that we're not done with this first exercise yet, but has the response from the communities been sufficient to encourage the board to make this more of an annual kind of?
I think we have a ways to go before we know whether it's going to succeed well enough to be in. And this is the end of the year, month, where your savings during the year and there's a little mess at the end. I may have told you all in the past, I scared the poor county executive all the pieces 2 years ago, but I said, I think you should just put $1 million in 6 or 6 buckets and then have those things go forward and you wouldn't have it more backstabbing trying to take the money from one district to another. So this is how it's evolved, and it's a great start, and we'll
just have to. So next year, $1 million.
Dream on.
Yeah. I'll put that in the chart.
Sam, I have a question on the overall allocation of funds. Does it look like every each of the 7 areas have projects that require $400,000?
I don't have any information. Because as Emily said, there's some that are still trying to figure out if they want to do a bus shelter or a sidewalk.
And if one or two of the areas said, you know, we only need 100 or 100 or whatever, would we still be giving out the same total amount? Would you then prorate that amongst the other areas?
Great suggestion. I don't know the answer to that. The, we have a list of projects as long as there are. Developing for 15 years.
It won't be the first. We canceled before.
That's great, President.
So So should we need a motion for that? I make a motion that we waive our meeting for August, year of September.
Second.
Please sign the minutes, so before you leave, since we're leaving, so.
Before we go, can I have a question?
Possibility of seeing that putting a stop sign from Gavin's labor. You know, who was saying that there is traffic there?
What do you want to do?
Put up stop signs to get out of Charming Gap Road, so it's joining Gavin's favor back to the area.
The last conversation I had with Tolman's and Robata, I think I was beginning to make some progress, and I think only because it knows I'm not going to stop asking, and so he's like, okay, I'll have to look into that. But I think it's just the Chinese water torture, because they've never done this before, or they will say, oh, those don't work. I said, well, it'd be so simple to put up four stop signs and see. It's not the end of the world. It's not going to cost $500,000 for traffic, but let's just put up some stop signs. One community where it doesn't, and it's been about a year that we've been talking about this, and I'll continue to do it, just, there's ways to do it, and then you bounce off about the first 25 times. But that was the case for roundabouts too, back in the 80s. They said, oh no, we're never going to go around them. Now they think they're one of them, so it is worth continuing to work.
We just talked to Noel about that, or?
Well, CCAC could certainly weigh in and send a formal request to the people to Joel to push this along.
Someone want to write that?
Not specific request.
Yeah, if you're for something about it, we can all agree on it. Send it to Joel.
I mean, make a motion that the CCA approve resolution. That would be sent to the FDS for consideration of stop signs. You have to better control Crozet and traffic. If you want to vote on that, all rights are done.
Can that be a motion or there? I think it is.
Second.
To get that, or someone put the light back on.
I'll second the motion.
And all in favor?
Aye.
And what are the arguments against stop signs there?
Well, they won't work without any real evidence.
Everyone just fun, willy-nilly.
The first thought I had was southbound Crozet Avenue, north of Broadway Avenue. Northbound Crozet Avenue, south of Tabor's. And then each person would be able to have a window to be able to get out. And then you'd have people, yeah, it's going to take some patience. Traffic's got people have to not run T-O-A to somebody who's also on your turn, but I think you got to be able to catch.
Yeah, you put a little green light on your side.
Don't you think if you stopped three ways at Library Avenue, I mean at Jarman's Gap, that it would also start to regulate Library Avenue without having to put additional signs there?
And say again, three ways?
Make Jarman's Gap a three-way stop like Tom is talking about. Even if we just did that, wouldn't that start to regulate Library Avenue as well? Because...
Do you think people would be able to get out of Library Avenue if the stop?
Yeah, I think if they were stopped at the red light and the traffic's back all the way up, you're then coming off of Jarman's Gap, you're on Crozet Avenue. I'm thinking you're going to have to stack cars all the way. That's the only thing I think about in the morning, especially.
I think that if it were to work,
it might work worse.
After the light of the square is either moved to Library Avenue or wrong. I mean, I don't know that it works on top of the light of the square, but they take the place of it and change that to the pedestrian crossing. All sorts of things up in here.
I'm sorry, the last time I saw the, what was supposed to be the final arena, was that light was gone in the square moving on the ground?
Yes, if we don't do anything else, that's still there. And the one, there still would be a pedestrian crossing, but it would be outside, but
I heard some sort of ballpark numbers, and we're slightly better than last year, you know, which is good. The turnout early in the evening wasn't quite what it was the previous year, but later in the evening, people came back for the fireworks. I think we turned out slightly ahead of last year. We increased the rate, the gate, you know, we asked for $4 instead of $3. So we're trying to get to the point where we don't have to fundraise for the fireworks show, because the event covers itself, but that doesn't happen yet. So we need to, we're closer, but we still need to raise about $8,000 a year from the community to pay for the fireworks show.
So, since you weren't there, I just got to tell you that the flags on the side of the street all the way up and down the ribbon.
Oh, I saw them go up before. Yeah, that looks great.
What is one of the programs for the bridge across the Great Eastern Protection Network?
It is
top of the
list for the secondary road, big project group, and it's working out around $11 million. Trying to move it, the various discussions have happened to move it a little bit west. And will that allow us to shorten it and be able to have $5 or $6 million, which is maybe a little more cost of it? Those discussions are all going around. So we do a lot of stuff around the wires, dragging people out to look at the wires to see where we can do it. But it is, we fit in at the top of the list, construction line. I don't advise it, but very good.
Really
important. Can I tell you an example? It would be the size of it would need to be
the first setup was the contacting over the airspace, you know, possible with the bridge.
It was supposed to be done as part of the rezoning that happened. So they decided not to do the super high density and they have to do it with the test stuff. So there are certainly people who are in the we have our temporary lights there now.
informed you that it's?
I would think so. And they're finally doing it for that. It's all down to that to decide the general value of that. As usual, get Crozet ideas are quite often in the big category where people go, oh, the answer is usually no about 25 times. But that doesn't mean it's number one bad question, or number two that it's not a good idea. And so I think that comes with a lot of these sort of attacks. We just have to push a lot of these ideas that we know will work for them. Terry on the end.
Came in.
this one, and this was not driving, so that would be taken out, but the result would stay. So it's double jeopardy over and over and over again. We get the no, and no one knows where we get that. So the big hope of the organization pushed this. They're very proud of it. They say they're fine. We've not had any results in 4 or 5 years. And when our small local builders hear that, they go, hey. Part of our problem in this community is with the recession. So many of the builders that are local builders have a hard time keeping their skilled craftsmen. So when they've gone off to do jobs in other places, and now that we actually have jobs for them to do either, they're having trouble staffing up and they're going to cost the projects for them. So it's a fairly vicious circle.
Any comments slash rumors about the acting office?
Since 2009, that's been, it's been ready 2 years over and over and over. So I do not have any confusion on that. Though I've been getting more ice, but they're still pumping, they're still having the wells back there.
Are their plumbing still clean?
The blue is not shooting.
Not shooting.
So that's good.
Nothing's been found in that unnamed creek line. I keep hearing that this year it could go to the market, but that's not official from the publicity department.
There's a light industrial or a duplex property.
So the building and all the acres?
The building's wrong.
If the building falls, so is that all that acres might be worth the one that's?
That's a high degree building.
And it comes down into foothills.
So the wonderful thing about it is it can have a district, which helps protect it as a climate change.
Well, now, there, I thought there was 50 acres on the south side of the railroad. Oh, okay.
One back at Mount Morton, just a little bit along that on the south side.
That was the presentation they gave last year when they asked if we talked about the zoning of that. They talked about that small part to the south of that, that's going to be moved over into the foothill, you know, crossing phase, whatever it is. So that's the part that is now on by red light.
Press this.